We're here this afternoon in our conference room. Unite BVI Foundation is here with the Ministry of Natural Resources and Labor, Honorable Minister Vincent Wheatley and his Permanent Secretary, Dr. Marcia Potter and his Deputy Secretary, Mr. Joseph Smith Abbott, and the Ace Laverty Stout Community College, Dr. Richard Georges and Dr. Leanna Jarecki. This grant agreement, which we're going to sign today, is for the creation of a mangrove nursery at the college. So before I pass the microphone to the minister, I'd like to thank the college, as per usual, for being an excellent partner. The grant proposal that they submitted to our organization was flawless. So we're very happy at this juncture to move this project forward.
Today I am overjoyed to see this finally come to fruition. I've been trying to grow mangroves for a very long time. There's been a lot of talk about mangroves for a very long time. So I must first thank BVI Unite BVI, for making this possible through a generous grant. And I want to thank Dr. Leanna Jarecki for agreeing to lead this program. I know she did an excellent job at the college up there. You know, the mangroves are very, very important to our ecosystem, as we all know. Not only do they protect the near shore, it also serves as nurseries for fish. Apart from being able to replace the damaged mangroves that happened after the hurricanes in 2017, should we have another occurrence of a hurricane, we cannot replace those mangroves at an even faster rate. So it's not only replacing all mangroves, it's building the capacity, should it happen again, to replace the mangroves. We are looking forward to having organizations like Rotary and all the schools participate in this program, learn to grow the mangroves and learning to plant the mangroves, learning more about mangroves. And hopefully in the near future, we can see mangroves as a protected species of plants that we want to make sure are around for a long time to come. So again, I'm really happy to see this finally come to fruition. It's the first of many bold steps we're going to be taking towards protecting this very pristine environment. It's very, very dear to us. We must make sure we do all that we can in this age and this era and this time to make sure the environment remains pristine and sustainable. So thank you all again for making this possible.
I'd like to lend my voice to the two that preceded me. And I would just like to say that the college, you know, being a community college, has to be minded and mindful of the ways in which it can buttress the needs of the BVI. You know, so the obvious dimension of it has been academic, but there are numerous ways that the college can lend assistance and value to the community. But with respect to mangroves in particular, you know, we have prior, you know, so with respect to mangrove replanting, and actually it's funny enough, Dr. Smith, when she was at the college as an advisor for Phi Theta Kappa, Mr. Smith Abbott, when he was director of National Parks, and the current director of National Parks, Dr. Sandy Titley O'Neill, all joined together and actually had a mangrove replanting initiative with the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society on our campus. So I see this as a culmination, as a sort of regularization and a formalization of the work that the college has already been committed to doing, you know, in its own little way. And now we can do so in a much more substantial and systemic fashion. And I think we would not have been able to do so without the return of one of our prodigal daughters, Dr. Leanna Jarecki, you know, who has come back to pick up the mantle again and continue to do the good work she was doing in the past. And I wouldn't want to steal too much thunder or say too much more, but I think if Dr. Jarecki can let us know a bit more in terms of the particulars, in terms of how this nursery is going to operate and what we plan to see out of that nursery in the future.
Okay, thank you, everyone. So the idea of the nursery is to build capacity for the BVI to regenerate mangroves in areas that have been damaged, as Honorable Wheatley had said. And as many of us know, the damage to mangroves has been really apparent since the hurricanes, but we've experienced quite a lot of wetland replacement long before that. And because of that, we have flooding issues and erosion issues that we know that mangroves are particularly good at mitigating. So as we produce mangrove seedlings and engage the community in outplanting, we're looking both at restoring areas that have been damaged by the hurricane of 2017 and also finding ways to develop hybrid infrastructure. We can take areas that have been developed and stabilized with rock walls and experiment with ways that we can put a layer of mangroves there to increase the resilience of those areas to climate change effects like storms and sea level rise. I see the advantage of this mangrove nursery at the college being as a platform for education in our community, but also for our students who can be engaged in this sort of research that is relevant to our community and to our survival as the effects of climate change increase or continue to affect us.